Thank you. thank you for coming today to share music with me. It's really a real pleasure to play this wonderful organ in this incredible acoustic. Normally, concert halls are very dry. This is the closer to a European church I've ever played in the United States, I guess. So it's really my pleasure to play today here for you all. So the next piece in the program, this Bach chorale, is one of those chorales I normally was using for encore, but was creating such an impression in so many people in the audience I decided to put in the program itself. The idea behind it is, well, it's too long to explain right now from a theological point of view, but Bach, in a way, is comparing the born of the Jesus Christ with the rise of the sun, like the light coming to the earth. And he does that by writing music that really reminds me to a morning, one of those beautiful spring mornings, where you can still feel the humidity from the night, but the sun is coming up and you start feeling the warmth from the sunlight. And that's a little bit the spirit Bach uses in this music, to bring that theological idea of the Jesus Christ being born in Christmas. So then I will play some Spanish music. I don't normally do, but many people ask me to do, so finally I decided to. For this music, if any of you is an organist or knows anything about organ music, you would think, well, Spanish music used to have those chamats, which are those trumpets on the top, which are in a horizontal position. That's very typical of Spanish. But actually, people relate that with the batalla. Batalla means a battle from a war. So they think those trumpets are like canyons in a war, in a battle, and then the Spanish people writing batallas, war music. That's because the Spanish people is very violent. Well, sorry, no. The answer to this is the first batalla, the first battle music writing in music history was by Clement Jeannequin. He called that La Guerre, and it was a vocal music, Franco-Flemish, 1500 vocal music. So it was actually a Flemish French idea to write music for war, to talk about war, to talk about battles. But Flemish music was so popular in Spain during the Baroque period that many Spanish Baroque composers start writing music like the Clement Jeannequin La Guerre, his piece about battle. And that's how the Spanish end up writing batallas. And then when those trumpets came in, most of the really important and good Baroque composers in Spain were already dead. So none of them ever met any of those horizontal trumpets. So the relation between those trumpets and the Spanish composer writing batallas, battle music, there is no relation, sorry. So the one I will play today, what you have to think is just following the same thing Clement Jeannequin does. This music follows the structure of a battle. So at the beginning, like Clement Jeannequin does, you have an introduction where he says, like, welcome everybody, I'm going to explain you about this wonderful battle that happened in this year, in this region, and these people, and these people fighting too. Then I will go into the trumpet, and you will listen like the battle starts, and it becomes more rhythmical. So it will be like the marchmen or the horsemen, like they would say in the time, marching into the battle. And then there is a second section that would be a different part of the battle, and then you can listen like a drum playing and a bagpipe. I will play a bagpipe with my feet, and then there will be a solo trumpet in the fourth coma, like the trumpets they used to use in the Renaissance and Baroque battles, batallas, to organize people and say, now you come. So it's all like the structure of a real battle, but there is nothing writing about, so I cannot really guarantee any of those is what it is. Just let your imagination fly and draw up your own battalion. So here I'm going to play now Bach chorale and Sebastián Aguilera de Heredia, Tiento de Batalla. Perfecto. I hope you like it. Thank you.
Thank you.
is in the program, Mephisto Waltz. The reason why I make transcriptions for organ is not to play something special, is not to play something different, and is not to do any kind of fancy stuff. My only intention with my transcriptions is I pick up the organ at a very late age, and I did consciously, because that instrument there allows me and anyone playing it to play any kind of music we want. Transcriptions is part of what the organ is. The first organ works, the first music ever written for organ were transcriptions. And Bach himself did many, many transcriptions for organ from orchestral works from his time. So that means that as an organist, I can play a wonderful, huge organ repertoire, but I can also play anything written for chamber music, orchestra, piano, or anything. And as a musician, that has so much value to be able to have all that huge musical repertoire under my hands, that how to say no. That's why I always think that the organ is the most wonderful instrument I could have ever picked up to become a musician. Now, if I would play the violin, and I love the violin, but if I would have picked up the violin as my instrument, I could make a transcription of Mephisto Waltz for violin. But I wonder, you wouldn't be here to listen to that today. So that's what the organ has that other instruments cannot really offer, that ability of put a whole orchestra under the hands of one single person. Now that I say orchestra, most of you would know about Mephisto Waltz by Liszt or by his piano arrangement. Mephisto Waltz is not a piano piece, sorry. It was a tone poem for orchestra that became so popular that Franz Liszt decided to make even more money by making a piano arrangement. And when he made his piano arrangement, it was sold out, but there was not enough organ people out there by the time to make an organ arrangement like he did from other of his works, the arranged for organ. So here I am. I decided this music is too wonderful, this music is too good not to play. So I decided to make this arrangement for organ. And because I only arrange music I like and I love, I am actually very happy to share that with all of you today. So I hope you like it. Thank you.
Thank you.
from Johann Sebastian Bach, Toccata in C major.
Thank you.